Welcome to Toy Hill Studio. My name is Kendall Kessler. I put up painting demos and studio tours. Please like and subscribe, and please check out my intro video. In 2 minutes, you can find out where I've been, where I'm going, what my goals are, all about me. Last time, I did what I call a suggestions painting. That's when I paint in an abstract expressionistic way, which is, you know, really putting paint and just reacting to the colors and the brushwork. And then if I see something, I bring the shapes out. And this time, a lot of things turned out. There's a deer there, a snowman, a figure with a tablet, looks like kind of a harp thing, a bull, and a bird over to the right. I didn't really add any of these. I kind of brought them out a little bit, but basically they were there. So that turned out really well. Now I've decided to do another Skyline Beauty painting. This is going to be a Pittsburgh. I have three, and I like to have five of each place that I do. And I'm really not sure what I want to do with this one. I am going to write myself a note and make sure that this week, without fail, I order some more paint because I'm just about out of the blue-green I need. And this particular cobalt blue that I really like to use for these, I don't have it at all, which really surprised me. But anyway, I was thinking about kind of like a, since there's the curve here in this particular view in the sideline, skyline, that curves like there, I thought I might do a lot with that. And I'm going to use a medium-sized brush. And not sure how thin or thick. I'm just going to really wing it. And I'm going to start with that and then work my way up. Might turn into more like water or not, I don't know. But one of those days, it's been a little tough. I can't believe what I just did a little while ago. I was drinking tea in this really nice rocking chair we have, real soft and all, and I dumped it all over myself, and I was screaming because it was really hot. My poor husband, like, he was downstairs, what? Did you fall? What in the world happened? And he came up to find that I had dumped tea all over my lap, and now I've got these great big burns all through there. I don't know if they're gonna blister or what, but it was so bad that it just made me scream. There was no way I could have prevented screaming because of that. And I'm just going to really just kind of play around with this one. I really would like to have that blue, and I'd like to have more green, but do the best I can and write that note, put it by the computer. I'm not going to go another week without ordering the colors I need. Even though I can do a lot with these colors too, but I really, really like to have a very strong cobalt blue for these acrylic paintings. It just seems to really work well. Don't use as much in my oil paintings, but in these acrylic ones, I really, really like using that. I've got a blue there, but it's kind of a, not a really very interesting blue in my opinion, or, you know, it's kind of a flat, what we call a flat color blue. But that's all right. Been seeing a lot of fun stuff for Christmas on Facebook, and a lot of jokes and all. So I think I've said before that for me, Facebook is really a place to put my artwork up, say happy birthday, and look at the jokes, because that is what I like about social media. I love to laugh, and the Santa ones especially crack me up. There was one today that was real cute. Santa Claus asked a nurse, "What do you want for Christmas?" And she said, "A dragon." And Santa said, "Be realistic." And then she said, "Okay, a complete unit with a completely full unit of nurses." He said, "What color dragon do you want?" I know right now, I do feel so sorry for nurses and doctors. It's really rough. I keep reading of places where they're full in their ICUs, and they're really having a hard time. I think too many people think that things are so much better with the pandemic, but it's not really true. Personally, it's my opinion, this may be kind of silly, but it's my opinion that the main reason a lot of people think it's not so bad is we have 333 million people in this country. We're closing in on a million loss. I'm going to use it thicker here and see what happens. Loss of life. A million out of 333 million? We're not talking the guy next door, the girl next door, the kid down the street. It's not that many people when you compare it to 333 million. And that's my opinion. It's the reason a lot of people are thinking, oh, it's not that bad. And they're just over to do it on the media and all that stuff. Just my opinion. It's the numbers thing. You know, if we had just a million people, we're getting close to that, or, you know, a couple million. Yeah. Whoa, this is awful. Everybody's dropping like flies. It's like the plague. But, you know, you're not seeing everybody around you dying because it's just not that many in the whole population. But I like what's happening with this. It's cool. I like the way that's really dripped. And then up here, I'm playing off of some areas that aren't moving around so much. And that's one of the things that artists will talk about a lot is, you know, contrast. Contrast in size, contrast in technique, different kinds of brushwork, contrast in color. And I like the way that's happening. I might just leave that like that. I probably will. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with the sky. I was thinking of doing that curve thing in both places. So I don't know. With these, I like to really be experimental. If you've watched my YouTubes before, you know that I like to really experiment with these. And I'm getting ready to do another wildflower painting in oils. Still haven't gotten to it. That will be what my main stuff, which is, if you had to put a name on it, would be Impressionism, Expressionism, somewhere in there. My two favorite types of artwork, and it's unique to me. You know, I mean, come on. Sure, you can see that in that, but it's certainly unique to me. It's my own style, my own work. But with these, I'm just really just rocking out, just having a cool time, really having fun with the colors. Trying to come up with something that is very interesting to look at and very inventive. And I like what's come along. I do miss my cobalt blue, but I think it's come along fairly nicely. Yeah, kind of cool. Before I got started, of course, something else happened too. You know, it's one of those days. That's just, sometimes we get those lovely days where things really screw up. And one of my tubes of paint had some excess liquid in it. So I got my palette out there, got everything in, and then put that one out, and it's all over the place. So I had to carefully pour it out so it wouldn't go into all the other colors. Just one of those days. I wonder what else is going to happen. I was going to go make some brownies. I think I can safely do that. It's only been 8 minutes, so I'm really having fun with this. I try to come up with so many different type approaches to this, and I will have the link to this painting, the final painting, and the link to others of my Skyline Beauty series. And please check it out, because I'm real proud of all the different kinds, the different approaches I have come up with. I have so many of them in so many different places. Oh, I like that violet there. Let's try not to have it so magenta. I got a new magenta color that I'm having trouble using. I'm tending to have it too dark, and it's just not working out real well for what I like. So I'm trying to dilute it down, add some pink into it. Okay. Well, certainly is expressive. I always like it when it drips like that. That looks cool. I probably will not touch it. I could go back into it and do a whole lot to it, but the way it's bled now, wet and wet, whatever you want to call it, It'll most likely mess up if I do anything to it. So, now what do I want to do with the sky? I don't know. I know one thing. As I said, I'm going to go write that note. Because I am just about out of this color, which I use a lot of. Phthalo green. Blue green. And I don't like being out of that color. So I'm going to write that note. And I'm going to get these colors I need. Before I do the one next time. Okay, yeah, I wanted to really just really be wild with this one, and that's certainly what's happening. Some of them I have more of a plan. This one I really just want to play. I like doing that, going back into it with the swirling stuff too. I don't think I have one like this. I've done a whole lot of them, different cities and all, and I don't think I have one just like this. think this is quite different. All right, I'm gonna do some sky before the time's up because I like to just go 15 minutes. I don't know, what do I want to do? I wonder if I just, I don't know. Get another brush, get a cleaner brush. I want to stay with this size brush. Could get a lot smaller and all, but I really want to have some broad sweeping strokes. So let's see. Maybe I could use a lot of pink. I really get into pink, especially when I combine it with this nice yellow. And just do some squigglies. Oh wow, yeah, that gets it very energetic. Well, I'm definitely sticking with what I was going to do, which is really let the paint go and get real energetic with it. Husband and son are upstairs watching TV, and I tell me I'm going to do YouTube, so keep the volume down. They're doing a great job. I can't hear it. Usually when I do this and I say that to them, I go up thinking they haven't even, don't even have the TV on, and they do. So the studio's good enough far away from the noise, which is great. Boy, this one is really wild. I am really getting into the brushwork. Yeah, that's cool. So then you got the pattern of that, played off of this, played off of that. Something different in each area. I know I should use some other colors. I really get into the pink and the yellows. Let's see. 11 minutes, I don't want to go too much longer. It takes, as I've said before, it takes forever to upload on my computer. We have got to get busy and getting a new computer. Because I don't think that's right. I don't think it's supposed to be like that. I suppose it take forever. But my YouTubes take, God, most of the day. Yeah, I'm not real crazy about the blue edition. Well, yeah, that's better. Just needed some white. Yeah, still might work on this afterwards, but probably not a whole lot. I think I really like this really wild one. Well, it's just really so much about brush stroke, color contrast, energy. Probably not the way a lot of people see Pittsburgh, but I don't know. You never know how people see different cities. Right out of things to say. Okay. I think I'll probably stop it there and probably gonna go back into it and make it a little more colorful. Lost some of the swirls there. I'll lose these swirls. And then I'll have another one in Pittsburgh, so that'll be four. If you look at the others, you'll see something completely different. Yeah. Probably just gonna like fill in these areas a little more and maybe do a little more in the sky since it's not really bleeding. I feel like I can go back into that and really just get it more and more expressive if I decide to go that direction. And the rest, probably just leave it the way it is. Like I always say, for me, and I think for a lot, if not all artists, it's a matter of control and accident. You control things, but then things show up and you decide whether you want them or not. And it's quite a balancing act. And I do that in all my paintings. Okay, I think I'm gonna quit right there. Well, thank you very much for watching. As I said, the link to the painting will be at the top of the description. The link to my other Skyline Beauty paintings. Link to my Etsy shop, website, and other sites that have my work.